I rise today in support of equal treatment for all Americans. The Employment Non-Discrimination Act, or ENDA, is aimed at protecting all lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender Americans from workplace discrimination based on their sexual orientation or gender equality. All Americans deserve to be free from discrimination in the workplace, and ENDA is a crucial step to ensuring equal treatment. I have been a co-sponsor of the Employment Non-Discrimination Act every time it was introduced in Congress since the bill was first drafted in 1994. 2 years later, in 1996, I was one of only 67 members of the House of Representatives to vote against the Defense of Marriage Act. That seems like ancient history now, so long ago. And I am proud to say that the Employment Non-Discrimination Act has its roots in my home state of Massachusetts. Back in 1994, it was originally written by two titans of Massachusetts politics, Congressman Gary Studs in the House of Representatives and Senator Ted Kennedy here in the United States Senate. We're coming up now close to 20 years since those bills were introduced first in the House and in the Senate. And while neither of these visionary leaders are with us today, their tireless work for equality lives on. They helped pave the way for this debate by challenging the pervasive view that LGBT people are not and do not need or deserve the same legal rights and protections as everyone else. We began debating this actually in the Massachusetts state legislature in the mid-1970s. And in Massachusetts in the 1970s, a law like this could not pass. But in 1989, Massachusetts became the second state in the nation to adopt a law prohibiting discrimination based on sexual orientation in employment, public accommodation, housing, and credit services. In 2004, Massachusetts became the first state in the nation to extend marriage equality to same-sex couples. Massachusetts is again paving the way with the passage of one of the first transgender equal rights laws in the nation. The people of Massachusetts know that when some of our citizens are being discriminated against, the liberty of all people is diminished. From schoolrooms to boardrooms, members of the Massachusetts LGBT community have made stunning progress towards full legal equality. And simply put, equality works in Massachusetts, and it works for Massachusetts by ensuring that LGBT individuals have the same employment protections as everyone else. We have made the light of liberty in our state burn even more brightly. And the same basic civil rights protections that have been extended to LGBT residents of Massachusetts should be extended to LGBT people across the entire nation. For the last two decades, the people of Massachusetts have supported a national employment non-discrimination law because we cannot allow our nation to have one standard in states that pass laws that protect people from discrimination and to have other states that do not. We cannot have the careers of people, the dreams of people to be in fear of prosecution as people move from state to state. This should be a national standard which we establish, a standard that ensures that every person knows that wherever they are in the United States of America, that they are going to be protected, that they were created by God, and that they have a right to these protections in every state in our country. Today, the number of states that have adopted their own anti-discrimination laws are basically increasing. And I applaud the progress that has been made to advance the cause of equality on the state level. However, 29 states still do not have these critical protections in place, and that is 29 states too many that still refuse to provide those protections. In the end, Madam President, it comes down to this. We should treat others as we would like to be treated ourselves. The LGBT community is made up of our friends, our neighbors, our co-workers, and our families, and we all deserve the same rights, regardless of who we are, regardless of where we live in our great nation. That is what is truly exceptional about America. Despite our challenges, we remain the brightest beacon of freedom, opportunity, and equality in the world. Madam President, I have a great deal of pride in our nation and our people. I truly believe that despite our differences, we can come together with one voice to say that discrimination is wrong. So let us here this week all stand together for a future without discrimination in the workplace. It will make America more productive. It will make us more wealthy. But most important, it will ensure that we have removed that stigma of discrimination that puts fear into the hearts of American citizens unnecessarily. This is a huge historic week that we are about to see unfold in our nation's capital, and I pray that we can pass this bill and send it over to the United States House of Representatives so that we can have this full debate in our nation for equality for every person who lives within our boundaries. And with that, I yield back the balance of my time.
Under the previous order, the Senate.